You know, Henry used to always tell stories in between our lesson. And one thing I want to come up, I want to say is, when I was coming up, Mahavishnu was a very big, making a lot of noise in the New York City community and the world. And John McLaughlin said something very interesting. I was just a little kid, and he said that spirituality is worthless if it isn't practical. And my job as a musician, and that's what's tangible to me. And whatever is spiritual to you, that's, you know, your own business. But to me, music is spiritual. And I think that it's Henry's teachings were great for the physical, the mental, and the spiritual, whatever that is to you. And I put that to drums. As far as physically and mentally, Henry gave you the facility to do pretty much whatever you wanted to do. You know, if you worked for it, and if, you know, you have the talent to want to work for it. And spiritually, it was, which is for me, that's what music is to me. I think it's a good thing, and anything good is, it's got nothing to do with religion. I think playing the drums is a beautiful thing, and it's a good thing. And I think I was one of those people that I wasn't going to be happy playing light jazz drums for the rest of my life. I wanted it all. I wanted to become a great musician. My father is a brilliant musician, and I grew up with him, you know, sitting on recording dates watching Bernard Purdy as a little boy. And my dad's a brilliant musician, and he would, a brilliant man, and he would say things to me that, you know, that that resonated. And so that, I just wanted to say really quick, what I got from that was the physical and mental and spiritual thing was Henry gave me the facility to be able to take drummers and take who was musical, who could really groove, and who had a lot of technique. And I could take what I wanted from those drummers and create, get what was great from all these drummers and incorporate it into my life. And I think it's a threefold thing, you know. And I think that we have our rhythm to deal with, and then we have melody, which is a slight void on the drums, you know, because we don't deal with notes and stuff. Although some people try to, I guess, and but I think that we, you know, we have a lot. There's a lot there, and so I want to demonstrate the single stroke roll, and it incorporates again. My fingers are always wrapped around the stick, always. I have my fulcrum point, which I see a lot of guys, you know, they'll go in. The fulcrum point with Henry was always on the first groove of the forefinger and the wrist. And I'm going to play it for you closed. I'm going to play it open with incorporate my forearms. And I'm going to do a little showboating. And I'll show you what I came up with traditional grip, which helped me, which I saw Tony Williams do eventually. The single stroke roll, it's doubles and it's singles. Everything we play in drumming is one and twos, no matter what you do. And the thing with this single stroke roll is you could do so many things with it solo-wise, and it just makes everything better if you have a good single stroke roll. And you younger guys, you know, it'll come. I put in many decades into this, but it'll come. So I'm just going to take it from off the cuff. And then I'll bring it up, and then we'll talk about it. Okay. I learned more from picking up then playing. What I did growing up is I did a lot of things when I was a little kid with that kind of speed, and it didn't work for something like a Billy Cobham roll down the toms and other things, and soloing. I was putting in too much energy, and it came natural to me to be able to play fast like that, although I put in a lot of time. More stuff you'll be able to do with the open technique than playing closed, which is you're not really gonna... I rarely... it's good for some things, but playing too fast is too fast. You know, you don't have to play that fast. So I don't want to make it like I'm showing off, but as far as rolling down the toms and combinations, you're better off picking up. Try to isolate the rest. And, you know, I see a lot of guys do stuff like this, and they look like they're in so much pain. They're like, oh. I mean, you know, it's something painful about it. You know, I think I do more grimaces with my face when I'm grooving, you know. So I saw one guy in concert, and it was, you know, he had a huge drum set, and he said, the snare drum comes up and floats and turns this way, and he's like doing a single stroke row. And he's like, his face is like so contorted, and I hope he's not in too much pain, but it's not that kind of a thing. And another thing I learned, traditional, was I would turn things around. Without really some, if I wanted some added speed, to turn the hand around, because we use more muscles with match group than traditional. And that never really came. I always could play faster this way a little bit, ever since I was a little kid. So, some great stuff there that you can learn, you know. And again, we start there, and I just thought I'd show you how I do a single stroke roll. And it's there's so much that you could do creatively, and it makes everything better. Everything better. And next time we'll work on the double stroke roll. Take care, guys, and next week.